the Rankine cycle. The Rankine cycle is an operating cycle of power plants, where an operating fluid is continuously evaporated and condensed. Today, it is in the form of steam engines that generates 90% of all electric power used throughout the world. The Rankine cycle was developed by William John Rankine, a Scottish engineer, in the 1850s. Like Clausius and William Thomson, who has been working on the theory of heat, Rankine attempts to derive Carnot's law. As we know, Clausius has derived the law from the postulate that heat cannot by itself pass from a cold to a hot body. Dissatisfied with this proof, Rankine deduced the law directly from his hypothesis of molecular vortices. This takes account of the interaction of heat and contraction, as well as expansion of elastic atmosphere. Before we dive into how the system works, let's look at the fundamental. The first law of thermodynamics. The first law of thermodynamics states that energy is always conserved. In other words, in a closed system, the change in the system internal energy is equal to the work done on or done by the system, and the heat added or removed. A closed system does not allow the transfer of matter, but energy is allowed to be transferred. Whereas the second law states that the sum of all entropies from processes in a system always increases. Entropy is defined as the number of arrangements possible for a thermodynamic system, commonly known as a measure of disorder. The slightest change in entropy is equal to the slightest change in heat flow at a constant temperature divided by the temperature of the system. As with every other process and phenomenon in nature, the Rankine cycle follows these two laws. Here are the idealized Rankine cycle, and to the right is the pressure enthalpy and temperature entropy diagram. The Rankine cycle operates in the following steps. In step 1, 2, 3, isobaric heat transfer occurs. High pressure liquids enter the boiler from the feed pump and is heated to saturation temperature. Then in step 2, further addition of energy causes evaporation of the liquid until it is fully converted to saturated steam. Note in the pH diagram that the process is done at constant pressure. Also that at saturation point, the temperature is constant, as you can see in the TS diagram. Now step 3 and 4, expansion occurs at constant entropy. This is the key step in power generation. The expansion of gas causes the turbine to rotate, thereby creating mechanical work from thermal energy. In practice, the expansion is limited by the temperature of the cooling medium and the erosion of the turbine blades. Exit vapor qualities should be greater than 90%. Note in the TS diagram, the entropy is constant. In step 4 and 5, this is the isobaric heat rejection. Heat is released via the full condensation of the liquid vapor medium, isobarically, until the substance reaches a saturated liquid. Here in the pH diagram, pressure is constant. Now step 5 to 1 is compression at entropy, constant entropy. The pressure of the condensates is raised in the feed pump. Because of the low specific volume of liquids, the pump work is relatively small and often neglected in the calculations. In the TS diagram, we see here that entropy is constant. As mentioned earlier, this is an ideal Rankine cycle. Real Rankine cycle operates slightly differently. Now, in a real Rankine cycle, to harvest more energy, it is common practice to superheat the vapor before it expands. Real engines are not a reversible process. Therefore, as stated by the second law of thermodynamics, real engine processes always allow some degree of entropy. As a result, the constant entropy steps are never really constant. Using the first and second law of thermodynamics, the heat addition, heat rejection, work input, and work output can be found using the following equations. If the temperature of the hot and cold reservoir are known, Entropies at each point can be found using the medium's saturation and physical property through databases such as the NIFT chemistry workbook. Using the heat and work values, the efficiency of the cycle can be easily calculated. Now let's move on to efficiency. Efficiency depends on the high heat of vaporization of the fluid. High heat of vaporization is the amount of energy required to convert the liquid to a gas. Thermal efficiency is defined as the ratio of the output to input. For any system that converts thermal energy to mechanical energy, such as an engine in a car, the maximum efficiency is called Carnot efficiency. This is described below. It is largely dependent on the T-hot, the temperature of the engine will operate at. Since T-cold will be the environment, Carnot efficiency is the theoretically maximum efficiency the high heat engine can reach in an ideal system. Three main ways to increase efficiency are reheat, superheat, regeneration. They can also be combined in one system. In reheating, temperature change from 5 to 6 is small. Regeneration. After turbine, the flow is split and some goes to the condenser, while the other go to the heat exchanger directly. In superheating, under normal condition, points are step 1 to 2 to 3 to 4. But when superheat points are 1, 2A, 3A, 4 are used. The overall efficiency is increased by using points 1, 2A, 3A to 4 because the area under 2 to 2A lines increases faster than the area under 3 to 3A line. And from this, the equation is obtained to be, we can see the fraction will get smaller if TH increases faster than TC. Supercritical, similar to superheat, except the boiler has a pressure that is higher than the critical pressure of the fluid, even more efficient than superheat. We can also have a combined cycles to maximize the energy production. In a cold generation system, the energy rejected by the Rankine cycle can be used for superheating, process steam, or other low temperature applications. Now, let's look at the application of the Rankine cycles. There are two types of Rankine cycle used in the real world, and this depends on the fluid. The Rankine cycle that uses water in the form of steam engines as the working fluid, and the Rankine cycle that uses an organic fluid such as N-butane or toluene is called the organic Rankine cycle. The Rankine cycle is used in the biomass, coal, solar, thermal, and nuclear power plants. It has been undertaken to enhance the efficiency and reliability of steam power plants. Since the Rankine cycle deals on heating up water in constant pressure while changing its phase, and this process has greater thermal efficiency compared to any other cycle. For the organic Rankine cycle, the organic fluid allows Rankine cycle heat recovery from low temperature sources, such as all biomass combustion, industrial waste heat, geothermal heat, solar ponds. The low temperature heat is converted into useful work that can itself be converted into electricity. This pretty much sums up the Rankine cycle. Please click like if you like this video, and hopefully our prof will give us good marks.